Before we look forward, let's look back. We are going over Juan Pablo's season of The Bachelor, and you were such a part of that in so many ways. What are your memories? What are your thoughts of that?
Gosh, it's crazy. It's still something that affects my life today, obviously. It was a big thing to actually go through The Bachelor, but how it ended up with me and him has just obviously impacted my entire life. So it's been such a journey.
You and I have talked about this before. There are defining moments, and I said it today. For him, it was going one way. For you, it was, you know, straight up the ladder, empowering, strong, loving, and understanding, and grace. So many things came out of that moment for you.
It really did. It took a minute. I will say that. It took a minute, and it took a lot of self-reflection, but it really was just growth from there. And it was that moment that just changed my life, honestly.
Have you thought later, were there things you wanted to say in that moment and you didn't?
I kind of want to thank him. And I know that sounds weird, but I want to thank him because if it wasn't for him, if it wasn't for this opportunity, I wouldn't be the woman I am today on some level. Not, I don't want to give him too much credit, but if it wasn't for that, and honestly, too, forgiveness, to let go, to move on, and to move forward, it's almost like carrying that brick around, that burden of something heavy and hateful that I just don't have in me anymore. And I am using it to build a house and using it for growth. So for me, I'm thankful to that, the situation, maybe, let's say that.
Overall, as you look back, what did you learn? What did you really take away?
Probably the biggest thing is realizing just how capable I am of great things, just as a woman, as an adult, and as somebody who has gone through a lot and learned to just love herself. Finding that within myself has just been the most amazing thing.
When you couple this defining moment during Juan Pablo's season, along with the years you've had now to think about it, how does it prepare you for what you're about to do as you're sitting there in quarantine, ready to become the Bachelorette, under extraordinary circumstances, no less?
You know what? It's actually weirdly given me a sense of calmness. I know quarantine has been crazy. It's crazy times in the world right now. But as I'm sitting here, there's excitement. There's possibility for the future. There's so much positive things in my mind and in my heart right now. I'm not anxious at all about this time. I'm excited for this time because I know from where I was to where I am now and the work that I've done, I have prepared so much for this moment. Meeting the man of my dreams, like I could not be more ready for this.
That's funny. I was just going to say, you just seem genuinely happy and excited for this, which makes me excited. It kind of gives me FOMO, actually, for not being there yet. You know, we're not going to be traveling the world. We're going to be in this bubble that we're creating. And yes, there's going to be dates and amazing situations, but it will be different.
Different in the best way possible, Chris. I want somebody who's not excited about the wonderful locations, which is great. And it's awesome to be able to go do those things, which I've done before. But this is more of what I'm looking for. Just real one-on-one connection or multiple connections. And just having the time to get to know each other way better and not having to focus on anything greater or bigger than that. It's the most important thing.
When you leave this bubble, you will have a ring on your finger, most likely. You're going to probably be engaged. Is that wild to think?
It's insane to think. You know, my mom, before I left, I was telling her that I kept reminding her that I'm coming here. And she, every day that I saw her at the window, she was like, do you have a ring yet? Do you have a ring yet? Do you have a husband yet? Do you have a ring yet? So she's just as excited as I am.